Hello and welcome to this very special episode of the Fact Flashes Real Talk. Now, 50 years ago, our enemy nation saw a dream. Saw a dream of having breakfast in Jaisalmer, having lunch in Jodhpur, and having their dinner in Delhi. However, the brave Indian soldiers, just 120 of them, made sure that this dream of theirs was broken at the same night that they saw it. Now, this evening, as we're all celebrating 50 years of the Longiwala battle that happened in the year 1971, between the 4th to the 7th of December, I have been joined by this three gentlemen whose services to the nation we salute every day and forever. What they have served, their service to the nation, will always be remembered. I've been joined by Group Captain Ashok Chhatre, who is from Air Force. We have Colonel Falnekar with us, we have Colonel Makwana with us, and over the next few minutes, as we're all celebrating 50 years of this battle that was fought between 120 Indian soldiers and around 2,000 to 3,000 Pakistani army men. Now, the Indian Air Force has a very, very, very important and a crucial role to play, had a very important role to play in this entire battle. Like I said, this dream that the enemy nation, Pakistan, saw, and they... When the Indians got hold of this one army man from Pakistan and they asked him what was told to him, he said that, we are just jawans on very small position, but we've been told by our seniors that, we're going to make sure that we have a breakfast in Jaisalmer, our lunch in Jodhpur, and our dinner in Delhi. But like I said, just 120 Indian soldiers, 120 brave Indian soldiers destroyed their dream overnight. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here with us. Like I said, we are celebrating 50 years of the Longiwala battle that happened in 1971 now. And in this 50 years, a lot has changed. A lot. We as a nation have come a long way in the field of wars, battles, and in the field of, like, in terms of economy as well. And after 50 years, like I keep repeating, only 120 Indian soldiers fought around 2,000 to 3,000 Pakistani army men. How do you see it 50 years later?
Okay. I have a little different opinion in the sense that these 120 soldiers were responsible for thwarting the attack and waiting till morning till the air support came. Main job subsequently of destroying the Pakistani tanks was done by the hunters of the Indian Air Force.
Right.
Without the air support, it would not have been possible for the army to hold for a longer time.
I'm sure. So. Right. So as sir said, that the Indian Air Force had a huge role to play as well. Colonel Falnekar, how do you see it 50 years later?
When I look at this Battle of Longiwala, rightly Group Captain said, and we were eagerly waiting for that kab Hawaii Jahaj Hamla Aayega. So we were not properly equipped that time.
Right.
Air Force night fighting, not equipped, I agreed. But these 120 jawans of 23 Punjab Regiment, uske upar border movie bhi nikli hui hai.
Ji.
See how they, what crucial time they must have gone through. When they send that Bhan Suraj, the youngster, Major Chandpuri ne usko bheja, you go and find out. Intelligence was failure, number one. When this boy went with 20 boys on the Reki patrol, there he could hear some sound. When the tanks come, 30 to 40 tanks are coming. That means it's a huge attack is going to come.
Right.
Unfortunately, if you see the Google, if you see the history also, the Pakistanis, when they came, we have a tradition of the training. हम हमारी पोस्ट के सामने बार्ब्ड वायर लगा देते हैं एंड द बार्ब्ड वायर के साथ देर इज अ वन रेड ट्राइंगल होगा व्हाट डज इट मीन द रेड ट्राइंगल मीन्स देर इज अ माइंड फील्ड दिस इज व्हाट इंटेलिजेंटली मेजर चांदपुरी डिड व्हाट एवर बार्ब्ड वायर ही हैड ही पुट इट इन फ्रंट ऑफ 200 मीटर्स लगा दिया उसने वहां सो दैट एटलीस्ट ही कैन टेक इट ऑन द रेंज टू देम ब्लॉक देम यस वी ऑल्सो हैव अ एंटी पर्सनल माइंड एंड एंटी टैंक माइंड NM-14 and NM-16 को बोलते हैं नॉन मेटालिक माइंस जो उसको इनके पास कंपनी लेवल के ऊपर बहुत कम थे So this youngster had gone there, he could put there, he was told to put something. Not only that, see the intellectual of our jawans, हमारे सरदारों का, उन्होंने जो हमारा मेस्टिन होता है खाने का, उसको भी जमीन में गाड़ दिया था. So that the one, they blown up two tanks.
Right.
By Chandpuri himself. Chalo, that is in history. But these tanks, when they came there, they were shocked. That barbed wire, that means there is tank. That means Pakistan didn't do any recce, number one.
Mm.
With such a huge force, you are coming, number two. Number three, they never had engineers. Engineers ka kaam ye hota hai ki bridge udana, bridge banana, wo minefield lagana, minefield ko nikalna.
Mm.
They never had this engineer element with them, Pakistan ke saath. They were under, rightly you said, they were under the huge impression ki desert hai, kya hai, there is nothing. We can just roll through. But the roll ke chakkar mein, which I have been telling you in earlier interview also, which General Malik said, the spirit is strong, the body is weak. Chandpuri was given an order by his commanding officer. And who was the commanding officer? A Muslim gentleman, Lieutenant Colonel Mohammad Hussain. He said, yaar, tu withdraw kar. Please withdraw because you can't take on or you hold it and die. He said, sir, ek khalsa, sawa lakho ke barabar, jo bhi unke bhasha mein bolte hain. And they maintained their, whatever best they could do, they had one BSF platoon also. We all seen in border picture also. So I'm very proud that at least jo 2.5 hours, 3 hours, he was praying, his friends are there in Air Force. They know that this is unfortunately, if they come rightly, they can come up to Barmer, Jaisalmer, and up to Jodhpur, they can go. Who stops them? But their reconnaissance was zero. Pakistan, their intelligence was zero. Their, the principles of war, that they have totally violated. In good faith, they said, "Okay, yaar, we'll come. What is this post? This post." But then, unfortunately, there is one gentleman, I will quote his name. He was my boss when I was a commanding officer in the valley, Brigadier Atma Singh.
Right.
That time, he was Major Atma Singh from Air Observation Post. And he was a great help to Air Force. Because helicopter mein jata, we had two field regiments. 170 and 168 field regiment, two field regiment, because I'm from artillery.
Right.
So yeah, they did a wonderful job, but problem was the communication.
Huh.
And but whatever it may be, these daredevil people today, they are celebrating Longewala, Battle of Longewala. If you go there, you feel proud. Yaar, in tankon ko barbaad kiya, inko rokna hi bada mushkil hai. Because tumhare paas kya hai, you have got only, nahi nahi, 7.62 aaye the, or we had 303 rifles. We had grenades. But nothing, I mean, you have to, either you die or you leave it.
Nothing huge.
And these are all Second World War type hamare paas tha us time pe.
Ji.
Thanks to the present generation, present things are a lot improving. That's what I want to say.
Right. Colonel, how do you see it 50 years later?
Yeah, this is a battle of Longewala. I want to add on something. So when the Pakistan is attacked, basically this attack was divided into two parts. One was the offensive, another was the defensive. So India was thinking okay, that now the Bangladesh, that initially the East Pakistan and West Pakistan. So when the partition was took place, so there were the two different states. One was the Pakistan that was known as the West Pakistan, and now Bangladesh, it was known was the as East Pakistan. So during that time, Indian diplomacy was thinking that now the grey area is that particular area, because now all focus of there only because of during 1970, that Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who the election was taken place and who was won the most majority, and he was going to take on there as a government. But due to this Pakistani Tanashahi and Pakistani generals, they were not liking that. Yahya Khan, during that time, he was the president of Pakistan. He decided ki now that Sheikh Mujibur Rahman is not supposed to taken over there. So he was specially taken the under arrest to the West Pakistan. And thereafter, the problem was started ki now the Longewala and other places, we were not ready. We were just only offensive. So, way the Colonel Falnikar said and Group Captain Chitre said about the situation. So, during that time, the period was very, very critical. Brigadier Meer, when he came there, he came to know they are having only 120 soldiers. So he says, you leave the place and go, otherwise you will be killed, all of them. He says, no. And he started his mind where he said, initially they were having only three mine. So they have put the three mines and rest of 120 messed in. The jawans are taking the food on that particular thing. So during that time, now, moment the one tank was blast, another tank was blast, and third tank was just overheating. Immediately, brigadier has given order, no, no, no. Our information was wrong. So now please stop it. Otherwise, all the tanks will killed Pakistani. Then he decided not to go further. So till the time that Pakistani was thinking our information wrong. 120 people cannot do such like a things. And during that time, the Major Chandpuri was having that intellectual. He sprayed all 120 people in a long, long ways. One person over here, another person there. And during night time, they made the complete bunkers.
Right.
So that everybody can take the shelter in the bunker. They will not damage by the enemies. So till the 3 o'clock, they have kept busy, all the Pakistanis. And after 3 o'clock, when they came to know, and then started firing each and everyone. They says, no, no, then they may not be 120. They may be thousand and thousands.
Yeah.
They had to go back. And Brigadier Meer said, you please go back. And with the help of intellectual, only two people were killed from our end. And from Pakistani side, so many soldiers were killed. This Patton tank was killed. After that, so many vehicle was damaged. And till the time, just we were waiting for the hunter fighter is supposed to come for the help. And till the time, 4-5 o'clock, everybody was ready. And first sunrise, immediately that hunter fighter had come and started operating. And then
pehli kiran pe these people dekhe.
Yes.
And they saturated the target.
Right.
Yes.
Unko naak mein bolte na dam, maine saans lena takleef ho gaya tha ki ye kaise total saturating the target done by the Air Force people.
Jee.
But the hats off to these people.
No, that's what my next question was going to be to Captain. That, you know, when such times come, you know, where you have to be there on the spot. You have no clue how the situation looks like over there, you know. So being in Air Force, what is like that first thought that comes to your mind when such situations or episodes turn up?
See, now in this particular case of Longewala, the hunters, which are basically a ground attack fighters, they were told that there is a big, around 30 to 40 tanks are approaching and they are attacking. And these pilots had only one mission in mind, that they have to go and destroy the tanks. And Pakistani tank commanders, they were crying on their phones and on their communication and asking for air support from Pakistan, which never came.
Right.
So the hunters had a free hand without any sort of a resistance from the Pakistani aeroplane, Pakistani fighters. So the amount of tanks they destroyed and with the accuracy that hunters attacked, the Pakistanis didn't know. The pictures that came in the newspapers next day, that there were so many tanks were going round and round to save themselves from the attack from the hunter aeroplanes.
Right.
So when the war begins and when you are going into the battle, nobody thinks about what is going to happen. So you only think about the mission that you have been briefed on. So I think they did a wonderful job, and they started attacking what we call the first light. First light is the daybreak, so they took off and they started attacking. So that was a big achievement by the hunter squadron.
Right, Captain. Colonel, 50 years after this entire episode that took place, the Indian Army is even more brave, even more well-equipped, even more prepared for things like this to come up. And what would be your messages to all of these young soldiers, youngsters in particular, who would want to get into the army?
Look, I was involved in Battle of Chum. If you see, I already sent a photograph to Manoj. It is the only place where India has lost.
Right.
इन वेस्टर्न बॉर्डर में बात करता हूँ, बाकी चकरगढ़ में वी हैव वन, ऑल दिस प्लेसेस वी हैव वन, इवन द ईस्ट पाकिस्तान तो पूरा सरेंडर करवा दिया उनको. द वॉट इज थिंक टूडे वेन आई सी, इफ यू सी हु वॉज द फील्ड मार्शल जनरल लेटर ऑन फील्ड मार्शल माणिकशॉ पारसी बाबा, हु वॉज सिटिंग देयर सरेंडर में, जनरल जगजीत सिंह सरदार. द मैन द ब्रेन बिहाइंड इज अ क्रिश्चियन फेलो जनरल जेकब, माई बॉस, माई कमांडर. इफ यू आर सीन द सरेंडर फोटोग्राफ विच इज बैंड इन पाकिस्तान, 93,000 प्रिजनर्स आर साइनिंग, जो उसका साइन कर रहा है सरेंडर सर्टिफिकेट साइन कर रहा है, ही इज क्राइंग व्हेन ही हैंडेड ओवर हिज पिस्टल टू जगजीत, जनरल जगजीत सर, जनरल न्याजी, जनरल ए के न्याजी, व्हेन ही वॉज आस्क्ड टू सरेंडर. तो एट टाइम टाइम सी, वन इज अ पारसी बाबा, वन इज अ सरदार, वन इज अ क्रिश्चियन, एयरफोर्स पीसी लाल इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, एंड एडमिरल नंदा,
द ब्यूटी ऑफ इंडिया.
सो यू सी इंडिया क्या यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी, व्हेन वी कॉल अनेकता में एकता है. मैं आज 2020 में मेरे बच्चों को जवानों को यही बताना चाहता हूँ, व्हेन वी कम ऑन टीवी, व्हेन वी सी ऑल दिस थिंग, वी फील वेरी सॉरी दैट सम ऑफ द कम्युनिटी, सम ऑफ द पीपल, सम ऑफ द पॉलिटिशियंस, दे आर डिवाइडिंग अस. 15 मिनट दे दो हम पूरे हिंदुस्तान को साफ कर देंगे, हिंदुओं को साफ कर देंगे. अरे यार, यहाँ पे जनरल आता हसन इज देयर, यू नो एवरीबडी, लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल आता हसन, द फर्स्ट महावीर चक्र अगेन ब्रिगेडियर साहब, वो भी मुस्लिम जेंटलमैन, परमवीर चक्र अगेन मुस्लिम जेंटलमैन, एन नंबर ऑफ पीपल आई कैन कोट, मुस्लिम्स हैं, हिंदू हैं, क्रिश्चियन हैं, सिख हैं, देन व्हाई आर यू डिवाइडिंग अस, हैवंट दे फॉट फॉर देश हित में, नेशनल सिक्योरिटी क्या, आई टोल्ड यू 23 पंजाब लोंगे वाला CO वॉज मुस्लिम, उसके दिमाग में क्या चलता होगा कि मेरी बटालियन की एक कंपनी वहाँ आगे बैठी हुई है, 120 जवान दे विल बी किल्ड, व्हाट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ही हैज गॉट, बस ही हैज वर्कड फॉर देश हित. इवन सर हैज गॉट गैलेंट्री अवार्ड इन द 71 वॉर, ही हैज गॉट अ गैलेंट्री अवार्ड. सो व्हेन वी गो इन फॉर अ मिशन, हम ये कभी सोचते नहीं है, वी नेवर थिंक दैट ही इज अ गुजू, ही इज अ महाराष्ट्रियन, वी थिंक ही इज अ ओनली फौजी. एंड फौज का हमारा धर्म यही कि इंसानियत सबसे पहले, देश हित में हम काम करते हैं, यही आपके जरिए में मैसेज दे रहा हूँ. यू सी ऑल दिस फोर फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कम्युनिटी, एंड देन पीपल से, वन जेंटलमैन रिसेंटली आई फील वेरी सॉरी व्हेन ही सेड देयर इज नो मुस्लिम बटालियन, दिखाओ, सॉरी टू यूज दिस वर्ड, 8 जैकले व्हेन आई वाज सपोर्टिंग इन 71 वॉर, वी हैव गॉट 2 बैटल ऑनर्स, ललियाली एंड पोस्ट 70, दैट्स व्हाई आई पुट ऑन माय कार बैटल ऑनर रेजिमेंट, आई पुट इट ऑन कार. That's in 13, that is the only regiment. In 13 days, they have got 2 battle honor by Rashtrapati, my regiment. Baki, we lost in Chham. But hamari post pe jab hamla hua 3 tarikh ko, 6 tarikh ko, 1000, I can't hear from this because I am from artillery. So, itna firing kiya, we ensured the commanding officer ke haath jale huye hai. Wo ammunition box ko haath pair mar ke tod raha hai. Raat mein jawan dekh raha hai. So, when we, as he rightly said, when we go in for a mission, mission kya hai? Deshit. नेशनल सिक्योरिटी, मैंने मेरी पोस्ट देनी नहीं, छोड़नी नहीं मैंने वहाँ. वी वर ऑल्सो टोल्ड विड्रॉ, मूव योर मोटर्स, मूव योर गन, बट वी नेवर सेड कि जब तक है विल फाइट टिल लास्ट मैन लास्ट बुलेट. इफ दैट इज द कल्चर इन इंडियन आर्म फोर्सेस, व्हेन वी सी टुडे इन 2020 में द वे द पॉलिटिशियन, वे द सम पीपल, दे डिवाइड, दे मेक अ स्टेटमेंट एंड द वेरी, आई डोंट नो व्हाई यू पीपल आर डिवाइडिंग. मैं यही इन बच्चों को सबको बताना चाहता हूँ कि यू सी हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई सब लोग हम एक मिलकर देश की रक्षा, व्हेन इट कम टू नेशनल सिक्योरिटी वी आर अबव ऑल.
एब्सोल्युटली,
यही मैं आपको मैसेज देना चाहता हूं.
जी कर्नल मकवाना,
आई वांट टू गिव अ मैसेज थ्रू दिस फैक्ट फ्लैश टू माय पीपल ऑफ इंडिया, पीपल ऑफ गुजरात एंड पीपल ऑफ बड़ौदा. इन इंडियन आर्मी नेवी एंड एयरफोर्स we believes in sarva dharma sthal, there is no religion in army, navy, air force, all religions are equal, so and it is at par also. So I want to give a message to all parties, political parties, where any disputes are coming or any political points are there, they are going at the bottom level. If the surgical strike takes place or Balakot strike takes place, so opposition party or any other parties, where they are taking and making a issue, and asking for a proof which is not acceptable to Indian Army, Navy and Air Force, because where we are, and before that also, this is only two highlighted, before that also we had done n number of surgical strike, n number of air strike, but being a the rule of Indian Army, Navy and Air Force, all the operations are supposed to be confidential. We are not supposed to go in front of the public and saying we have done this thing and that thing. So my point is, so as and when any difficulties are coming or any attacks or any such kind of difficult situation between the enemy like China or Pakistan, so India should be in one. There should not be any religion, there should not be any party, there should not be any personal benefit. So that message, just I want to give all my youth, all my people of India, Gujarat and Baroda too. And before that, I request my all the peoples, they must understand where the inclement weather in Galwan Ghati. As of now, the Indian soldiers, about 60,000 people, who they are fighting for the nations. They are not celebrating Diwali, Holi or Janmashtami. They are not celebrating any birthday party or anniversary party. They are not enjoying their social life. So at least, whatever the best possible help, what we can do from our end, we give them a respect. Any forces are coming to airport, railway station, bus station, at least give him a blow of hands. Just give him a respect. So this will message go to the bottom line, to the army people and all of them. With this, I conclude. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Jai Garvi Gujarat.
Right. Thank you. Sir, at the end, right. Just a few message. I mean, your message to the youngsters, young India in particular.
Message to the young Indians. Before that, I just want to give you a small episode. My son-in-law is a colonel in the army. He was in the Kargil battle and he was injured. He had a bullet injury. And when he came on short leave, I was in Ankleshwar and a lot of schools invited him and I used to accompany him. And during that one of the meetings with the school children, I asked a question that how many people would like to join the army. So there were almost 75% of the boys, they got up and we would like to join, because that was the josh. And I went to the same school after 5 years and I asked the same question. There was hardly one boy who stood up and said, I want to join the army. See, whenever there is a threat, whenever there is a likelihood of war, all the Indians, they fall behind the armed forces. But as soon as the battles are over, the people tend to forget. So I just want to give a message to all my brothers in the Indian nation that they must respect the soldiers all throughout and not
just when they win the
just
battles.
When they are required for you to defend the borders. You know, right. They have to have the respect and they must give due to the soldiers, the veterans as well as the serving soldiers. They deserve to be respected by all the citizens. Thank you.
GG sir, zarur.
When the Marathas go for the war, Har Har Mahadev. Gorkhas, Ayo Gorkhali Mahakali karke kukri leke last mein aapki gardan ek jhatke mein kaat dete. वैसे हमारे मुस्लिम बटालियन के जो मुस्लिम कंपनी है अल्लाह हो अकबर करके अटैक किया उन्होंने कमांडेड बाय सरदार कंपनी कमांडर सरदार इन कारगिल वॉर द पाकिस्तानी थॉट कि शायद मुस्लिम्स अपनी प्रैक्टिस कर रहे हैं बिकॉज सारे शाम को इन्फेंट्री वाले चार्ज प्रैक्टिस करते हैं लेकिन ये पता नहीं था कौन कमांड कर रहे हैं सिख मेजर साहब इज नो मोर राइट ही गॉट अबाउट बट ऑल दिस अल्लाह हो अकबर करके ये जो मेरे जिसके साथ में 71 वॉर में था 8 जैकलाई 12 जैकलाई 13 जैकलाई ऑल दिस बटालियन मैक्सिमम गैलेंट्री अवार्ड नो यू टेल मी दे आर मुस्लिम दे आर फाइटिंग मुस्लिम्स देश के लिए यही मैं इन बच्चों को बता देश के लिए हम लोग सब एट पार है यही लेसन जाना चाहिए और ये हम लोग सब भूल जाते हैं ये हम सब इवन आई डोंट नो वेदर यू नो जनरल आता हसन नाम सुना होगा लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल आता हसन वो वॉज द कश्मीर कोर कमांडर जब पार्टीशन टुक प्लेस हिज फादर इज ऑल्सो कर्नल ही वॉज आस्क चल तू आ जाओ भाई पाकिस्तान में आ जा, इवन फील्ड मार्शल मानेकशॉ वाज आल्सो आस्क्ड टू आ जा पाकिस्तान में, विल मेक यू बड़ी 2-3 प्रमोशन एक्स्ट्रा, दैट इज दे सेड नहीं वी विल फाइट इन इंडिया, हम बॉर्न इन इंडिया फाइट, ब्रिगेडियर उस्मान ही सेड आई विल डाई हियर, ही डाई देयर ओनली, जबकि 100 रुपये में एक लड़की बेची जाती थी पुंछ के अंदर, और उस टाइम पे उसके सिर के ऊपर 50,000 प्राइस पाकिस्तान ने लगा था, किल ब्रिगेडियर उस्मान, अभी भी उसके वहाँ पे वो मार्टियर का सब बना हुआ है। सो वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट दिस पीपल, यही हमारा मॉरल ऑफ द स्टोरी, वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट। लकीली मैम, मैं तो भगवान से प्रार्थना करता हूँ हम लोग जिंदा हैं, कुछ काम किया होगा शायद, वो भी हमारे सोल्जर थे, वी सल्यूट देम, मार्टियर हो गए, कुछ काम किया हुआ है तो आपके जरिए इतना अच्छा आपका एस्टेब्लिशमेंट है, आप हु वाज नोइंग अन्ना हजारे कौन है, इट इज मीडिया, इट इज द मीडिया, उसको मालूम पड़ा कि अन्ना हजारे, तो आप ऐसा अच्छा काम कर रहे हो और करते रहो विद द रिजल्ट, एक जवान की वैल्यू होनी चाहिए बस, हम यही है। और वही विक्टोरिया क्रॉस कुछ दिन पहले जनरल भगत अभी तो घर गए, और हमारा एक हवालदार था जब रास्ता क्रॉस कर रहे थे, लंदन में जाते हैं हर साल विक्टोरिया क्रॉस वाले सेकंड वर्ल्ड वॉर टाइप, तो उधर लोगों ने देखा तो पीपल स्टॉप्ड, जेंटलमैन वन गॉट डाउन, ही सेड सर आई एम मेयर ऑफ लंदन, प्लीज सर यू आर विक्टोरिया क्रॉस, सी द भारत के उमराव हवालदार, उमराव आर्टिलरी का, और ये लोग जो विक्टोरिया क्रॉस कॉन्फ्रेंस करके बाहर जा रहे थे, ये इज्जत हमारे नहीं है
जी,
हम लोगों को नहीं मिलती है, ये आपके जरिए मैं बताना चाहता हूँ, प्लीज एंश्योर दैट नाउ दैट यू आर गोइंग टू लोंगेवाला यू गो टू एनीवेयर, दिल टूटता है मैडम, दिल टूटता है यार, हमने इन देश के लिए क्या किया, हमारा भी बेटा कर्नल है, हमारे कई बच्चे हैं, तो कई गलती तो नहीं की मैंने, इनको गुजरात के बच्चों को ट्रेनिंग दे के ऑफिसर बना करके आज वो शहीद हो रहे, कई लोग शहीद हुए हैं। दुख होता है कभी जब ऐसा रिस्पॉन्स पॉलिटिशियन से मिलता है या पब्लिक से मिलता है, मैं कौन लाइन में उबारो, वी फील सॉरी फॉर दैट, धन्यवाद।
राइट, थैंक यू सो मच एवरीबॉडी फॉर बीइंग हियर विद अस, 50 इयर्स have passed the Longiwala battle and the josh is even more higher in the Indian Army, in the Indian Air Force and in the Indian Navy. Now to all these, the three gentlemen that we have, you know, we owe them a lot of gratitude for everything that they have done for the country, and to all the jawans who are serving for the nation, who are fighting for the nation, and like Colonel just said that, you know, the Indian Army has this one motto that we will fight until the last soldier and until the last bullet is left. With this, Fact Flash today expresses its gratitude to each and every Indian soldier. That the kind of service, the way that you are defending the nation is great, and that we salute each and every one of you. And today, as we celebrate 50 years of this amazing battle that was fought by just 120 soldiers and the Indian Air Force in front, there were some 2,000 to 3,000 Pakistani army men, and we won that battle. With this and a lot more that you need to know, make sure that you always stay tuned to the Fact Flash. Jai Hind.